Welcome back to Dragon Age Origins. I just remembered why I never do Redcliffe last. It's because a certain quest will not trigger until after you've went there. So, and that's Alistair's personal quest. So, you talk with Ogryn and Alistair, and then we're gonna head to Redcliffe.
There you are. Wanted to talk to you. You and I, we've. You know how sometimes you spend time with people and things? I was thinking, I do know some people out here on the surface. A person, actually. A girl I knew in Orzammar before I left, obviously. Her name's Felsey. She and I were friends after Bronca left for the Deep Roads. I'm sure she's forgiven me by now. Thought maybe I'd track her down, see how she's been living. I tried to look her up the last time we were at Lake Callenhad. She wasn't at work at the inn, at home with her sick mother, they said. I figured it was just the ancestors telling me something. But I keep thinking about her. Well, and a good friend you are, Warden. I'll think about you if we ever. No, actually, that would be gross. No, what was it you wanted to say? Aye, all right then.
So, all this time we've spent together, you know, the tragedy, the brushes with death, the constant battles with the whole blight looming over us. Will you miss it once it's over? There'll be no more running for our lives, no more darkspawn, no more camping in the middle of nowhere. I know it might sound strange, considering we haven't known each other for very long, but I've come to care for you. A great deal. I think maybe it's because we've gone through so much together. I don't know. Or maybe I'm imagining it. Maybe I'm fooling myself. Am I? Fooling myself? Or do you think you might ever feel the same way about me? So I fooled you, did I? Good to know. That wasn't too soon, was it? Good. I'll take that as a good sign. Make us breath, but you're beautiful. I am a lucky man. Now, let's get back to what we were up to before, lest I forget why we're here. Yes.
Indeed.
This is where Sten's sword is, too. Don't want him to have to. I think he kills the guy if he's there when you get it back. Like a matter of honor or something.
Look, can we talk for a moment? I need to tell you something. I should probably have told you earlier. I told you before how Arl Eamon raised me, right? That my mother was a serving girl at the castle and he took me in? The reason he did that was because, well, because my father was King Marek, which made Kaelin my half-brother, I suppose. Maker's breath, I hope not. I don't think so. You don't think so, do you? I'm a bastard. And nobody even knows about me. I would have told you, but it never really meant anything to me. I was inconvenient, a possible threat to Kaelin's rule, and so they kept me secret. I'd never talked about it to anyone. Everyone who knew either resented me for it or they coddled me. Even Duncan kept me out of the fighting because of it. I didn't want you to know as long as possible. I'm sorry.
So he's the Jon Snow of Thedas.
Why wouldn't he? He was King Marek's best friend. I don't know if that means anything, though. I certainly never considered the idea that it might ever be important. At any rate, that's it. That's what I had to tell you. I thought you should know about it. Oh, no, no, I don't like the sound of that. That's where you're going. It was made very clear to me early on that there's no room for me on the throne. And that's fine by me. No, if there's an heir to be found, it's Arl Eamon himself. He's not of royal blood, but he is Kaelin's uncle, and more importantly, very popular with the people. Though, if he's really as sick as we've heard... Oh, no, I don't want to think about that. I really don't. So there you have it. Now, can we move on? And I'll just pretend you still think I'm some nobody who was too lucky to die with the rest of the Great Wardens. Well, no. What I really think is that I was lucky enough to survive with you.
And that's why his personal quest doesn't unlock until after Redcliffe. You have to get that knowledge first.
I thought I saw travelers coming down the road, though I scarcely believed it. Have you come to help us? The Arl? Then you don't know. Has nobody out there heard? He could be dead for all we know. Nobody's heard from the castle in days. We're under attack. Monsters come out of the castle every night and attack us until dawn. Everyone's been fighting and dying. We've no army to defend us. No Arl and no king to send us help. So many are dead. And those left are terrified they're next.
Hold on, what is this evil that's attacking you?
I don't rightly know. I'm sorry, nobody does. I should take you to Ban Tegan. He's all that's holding us together. He'll want to see you.
Ban Tegan, Arl Eamon's brother, he's here.
Yes. It's not far, if you'll come with me.
And who are these people with you? They are obviously not simple travelers.
No, my lord. They just arrived, and I thought you would want to see them.
Well done, Thomas. Greetings, friends. My name is Tegan, Ban of Rhaenysphere, brother to the Arl.
I remember you, Ban Tegan, though the last time we met, I was a lot younger and covered in mud.
Covered in mud? Alistair? It is you, isn't it? You're alive! This is wonderful news.
Still alive, yes. Though not for long, if Tern Loghain has anything to say about it.
Indeed. Loghain would have us believe all Grey Wardens died along with my nephew, amongst other things. What, that he pulled his men in order to save them? That Kaelin risked everything in the name of glory? Hardly. Loghain calls the Grey Wardens traitors, murderers of the king. I don't believe it. It is an act of a desperate man. So, you are a Grey Warden as well? Is it possible we've met? You seem very familiar. Ah, yes, that's it, exactly. A pleasure to meet you indeed, though I wish it were under better circumstances. You're here to see my brother. Unfortunately, that might be a problem. Eamon is gravely ill. No one has heard from the castle in days. No guards patrol the walls, and no one has responded to my shouts. The attack started a few nights ago. Evil things surged from the castle. We drove them back, but many perished during the assault. Some call them the walking dead, decomposing corpses returning to life with a hunger for human flesh. They hit again the next night. Each night they come with greater numbers. With Kaelin dead and Loghain starting a war over the throne, no one responds to my urgent calls for help. I have a feeling tonight's assault will be the worst yet. Alistair, I hate to ask, but I desperately need the help of you and your friends.
It isn't just up to me. Though the Grey Wardens don't stand much chance against Loghain without Arl Eamon.
Thank you. Thank you. This means more to me than you can guess. Please tell Murdoch what transpired. Then return to your post.
Yes, my lord.
Now then, there is much to do before night falls. I put two men in charge of the defense outside. Murdoch, the village mayor, is outside the chantry. Sir Perth, one of Eamon's knights, is just up the cliff at the windmill, watching the castle. You may discuss with them the preparations for the coming battle. Very well. Luck be with you, my friend.
I almost want to sacrifice this town out of spite for his actions in Dragon Age Inquisition.
Let us pray. Blessed art thou who...
Why haven't mother and father returned yet?
Blessed art thou who seeks his forgiveness.
They're gone, dear boy. Gone on a long trip.
Blessed art thou who seeks his return.
You're a Grey Warden, right? Were you in Ostagar? In the Kokari Wilds? My husband and son went there to bring the Chant of Light to the Chastened. But I haven't heard from them since. I am. You've heard of me?
Been carrying this box around for the last 30 plus hours.
Oh? Oh, his lockbox! If you're bringing me this... Oh, no. I'm sorry. Thank you so much for bringing this to me. It means a lot to... Make his blessings upon you.
I'm scared, Mother. When are the bad men coming?
Soon, darling.
Everything will be all right.
I want to go home. Where's Father?
Yes?
Why can't we go home?
All right. Let me take a look. No, I can't believe this. I won't.
I already told you. Father was not in the village from the bad. We must be
I'm so scared, Father. What are we going to do?
Sorry. Am I bothering you? I'll try to be more quiet. My name's Caitlin, my lady. Pardon my manners, but are you really a Grey Warden? Honestly? No, you're so pretty, I never thought... I mean, I never expected... Never mind. Are you going to help us? Everyone says we're going to die tonight. I can't even sleep. I close my eyes. And I see my mother being carried off. What have we done that the Maker allows this to continue? I'm not worried about her. She's dead. I wish it wasn't so, but it is. It's my brother Bevin. He ran off, maybe tried to leave the village. I'm so scared those things got him. I went to our house. It's by the square. He wasn't there. I searched the rest of the village, too. I called and I called, but he never answered. I wonder if he ran off into the woods. I'm so worried. Without me, he has nobody. He said something about saving Mother. He's just a little boy. He doesn't understand she's gone.
Grief can make us do many things that don't make any sense, I'm afraid.
I hope he didn't try to go to the castle. Oh, that would be awful. You will? Thank you so much. Please find him.
Silence, girl. You want the children to hear you?
But night is coming. The monsters will return.
These people don't deserve what has happened to them. We must get to the bottom of this.
Still no sign of them coming back from the castle, Murdoch.
Tell them to maintain watch. I don't want a surprise attack before the sun goes down.
Yes, sir. What should we do until then?
Pray, and hope for a miracle. So you're the Grey Warden, are you? I didn't think they made women Grey Wardens. So you say, a damn Kunari could walk up and say he was a Grey Warden. I wouldn't know the difference. We aren't gonna turn aside anyone who wants to help, though. Don't take me for being an ingrate or nothing.
Well, we do want to help however we can. You can trust us.
Name's Murdoch, mayor of what's left of the village. Providing we aren't all killed and hauled off to the castle tonight. I hope you're right. I've been trying to hold us together, but it isn't easy. Anyhow, you're here, and they tell me you're in charge. We need what little armor and weapons we got repaired, and quickly, or half of us will be fighting without either. Owen's the only blacksmith who can do it, but the stubborn fool refuses to even talk. If we're to be ready for tonight, we'll need that crotchety bastard's help. His daughter, Valena, is one of the Alessa's maids, so he hasn't heard from her since this whole business started. He demanded we attack the castle, break down the gate, and force our way in. I said it was impossible, but he wouldn't listen. He's locked himself in the smithy now. I can't force him to do repairs. He said he'd rather die first. Not by nightfall, and not well enough that I'd be happy to test it in combat. If there were others, don't you think I'd ask them? I'd appreciate it. If he doesn't help, he'll die like the rest of us. What good will that do anyone then? Have you spoken to Owen? Is he not the most stubborn fool you've ever met? We could use some extra bodies. Having a veteran like Dwin in the militia would help a lot, but he flat out refuses. He's a trader, a dwarf, lives near the lake, locked himself up in his home with some of his workers, he has. Says he doesn't need any of us. We could use somebody with his fighting experience, but he won't come out. Shouldn't you be trying to reason with Owen? Don't drink with him. That's how he sucks you in. Just my luck, our success hinges on the most foolish drunk of a smith ever to grace the Maker's lands.
Watch how we finesse this door open. Haven't saved in a while. could pick the lock, but not going to. This guy's a sword thief. He's the guy that has 10 sword.
Wonderful. Intruders. I hope you've a good reason for breaking and entering into my home. You broke into my house for that? It must be worth something to you, then. Since he's not here, I don't see how that's my problem. I'll let it go for 6 sovereigns. The number's got a nice sound to it, don't you think? If that's all you want, sure. Now, why don't you take your sword and leave? So what? You recruiting for him? I'll tell you what I told Murdoch. I'm not risking my neck for this town. So, that's what it comes down to, huh? Fine. I'll go. If you want me out there so badly. Don't thank me. I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing this because of you. Go tell Murdoch he won. And I better see you out there in the square when those creatures come.
Finished.
Always use intimidate options here. So these villagers must think I'm a real hard ass. They don't get the nice persuade options.
I'm ready.
Guess the no swimming thing is probably like, imagine lakes in Thedas, or like lakes in The Witcher, full of drowners and stuff.
Away. This isn't your home.
Young man, come out this instant.
Yes, ma'am. All right, I came out. You won't hurt me, will you? I'll go back to the Chantry if you really want. I can't tell you. It's a secret. You could. All right, I guess. Father said I could have his sword when I grew up. It was Grandfather's. And Grandfather was a great dragon slayer. I thought, if I was brave like Grandfather, I could use his sword and kill the bad people who took Mother. In the chest, in Mother's room, Father gave me a key, but I'm not supposed to give it to anyone. I guess you're right. I should help defend the village, shouldn't I? Father would have if he were here. Oh, all right. Here's the key. I hope you use it to kill a lot of those bad people. I should go back to the Chantry. Good luck.
Wynn must have her intimidate skill up to max too. And she got him out of there. The stern grandmotherly voice.
It is over.
Why are you smiling like that? You look suspiciously like the cat that swallowed the pigeon.
Can you hear me?
What?
I look like the cat that swallowed the canary.
I once had a very large cat. Not my point. My point is, why are you smirking?
You were watching her with great interest and that I believe you were enraptured.
She's our leader. I look to her for guidance.
Oh, I see. So what guidance did you find in those...
No. I wasn't looking at, fine quarters.
Certainly.
I am done.
I gazed, glanced in that direction, maybe. But I wasn't yet. Already seeing.
Go away. Curse you. Leave me in peace. You've already taken everything out of my stores. There's nothing left. Alright, just don't destroy anything, damn you!
Make his breath! What is that smell? It's like someone set a brewery on fire!
Somebody's been drinking.
So? I open the door. I've got nothing of value for you. The militia's taken whatever I had. So if you're here to beat on a sad old man, then all I ask is you get on with it. I don't have much to live for as it is. Why should I help Murdoch when he won't help me? My girl, Valena, is one of the Alessa's maids and she's trapped up there in the castle, but the mayor won't send anyone for her. She's been my life since my wife passed on 2 years ago. Now she's dead, or soon to be. I don't care what happens to me or the village or anyone! You say I'm crazy? I'd say my daughter's all I've got to live for. Murdoch and the village don't matter. None to me! Tell you what. If you want me to do repairs for Murdoch and his men,
promise me you'll go into the castle and find my daughter. Not good enough. Murdoch said the same damn thing, and I didn't believe him either. I want a promise. Promise me that you'll look for her. That you'll bring her back to me if you can.
We will do our best. Please believe us, friend.
I'll accept that. It's something to hope for, at least. Right then. It seems I have some work to do, relighting the forge, and I suppose I'll have to find some iron. Maybe at the mill. Murdoch just better send his men here as soon as possible if I'm gonna get to all these repairs and get them done by nightfall. If you need anything done, well, just let me know. I've got a lot to do now, so you'll have to excuse me.
Got a couple more people to threaten in the getting out here.
What now? Another doomed soul come to drown their sorrows here, I see. If you came here for a drink, you'll have to talk to Lloyd. He's got a vice grip on the spigots. I'm just here to keep the boys from mutiny. Not much. He's very quiet. Says his name's Beric and he's here to meet his brother, but I think he's lying. He's a bit creepy. Later on, yes. Lloyd will lock himself in the cellar, and I'll go to the chantry. Are you fighting tonight? That's good to hear. I didn't know that. Keep safe.
Hello there, friend. Can't say we've ever met before. Stranger to the village, I take it. Haven't had many travellers lately. All this nonsense is bad for business. Bet you regret coming, yes? A shame, isn't it? Evil creatures and such. Everyone going to perish before sunrise. Makes you thirsty, don't it? So, what'll it be? You are here to drink, I hope. Right, I've got some supplies too, in case you're interested. With the store closed down, it doesn't hurt to pick up some of the slack, eh? What can Lloyd get you? Fine. Make them quick. Not much. Says his name's Berwick. Arrived here more than a week back. Waiting for his brother, he says. I've never seen him before, but he paid good for his room. Quiet sort. Not a lot. Castle guards stopped coming in about a week back. It's unusual, too. They were my main source of business. After a few days, I thought it strange enough to ask. But nobody heard anything. Anyone going up to the castle didn't come back. When the first attack hit, I locked myself in the cellar. I say we just wait for help to come. I'm not abandoning my tavern because of a few monsters. The second I'm in the chantry, Murdoch and his men will be here drinking all my ale. Something else I can get for you? Right then.
I hear they got everyone in the castle, and now everyone who died here too. They're all monsters now.
I can't believe Lloyd won't even give us some free ale. A time like this, and all he thinks about is turning a profit.
Did you expect any different? That bastard's always been cheaper than an ante from the hall.
Here we are defending the village, and he don't even have the decency to help us out.
This is just what we want. Bunch of drunks.
You're telling me? We're just trying to survive.
But actually,
he is making a profit.
Liquid courage.
What difference does it make? He won't care.
Hey, what can Lloyd get you? Why shouldn't I? They may not have much coin, but I'm not giving it away for free. I never thought of that. Maybe I could try it for a bit. Right then, you men over there. Drinks are on the house. All militia, drink for free.
Oh, you're a saint, Lloyd.
If them creatures don't kill me, I swear they'll bleed me dry. Something else I can get for you?
Now to thank him for his good deed.
Fine. Make them quick. Why? When them creatures attack, I lock myself in the cellar, just batten the hatches and wait it out. What's the point in getting myself killed with all the rest of them? If that makes me a coward, then I'm a coward. But Van Tegan said we didn't have to. He said... Fine, I'll go. But all of this better be here when I get back. I don't want a place drunk out from under me. Blasted bloody...
Not looking for company. What? How did you know that? Well, that's my name. Why? My what? Oh, yes. He was supposed to meet me here. And then I got stuck here when monsters from the castle attacked. No. Those who tried are dead. And, have to wait for my brother. Look, you're very pretty and all, but I was told to... just leave me alone. Nothing. Nobody told me to do anything. Just because you're a Grey Warden doesn't mean you can go around threatening people. I just, overheard it, that's all. If you'll excuse me, I want to get to the chantry before the sun goes down.
All right, I'll tell you. Just don't hurt me.
This is more than I bargained for. Look, they just paid me to watch the castle and send word if anything should change. But they never said anything about monsters. I haven't even been able to report anything since this started. I'm stuck, same as you, I swear. A tall fellow, I forget his name, he said he was working for Hal. Arl Rendon Hal. He's an important man, Taryn Loghain's right hand. So I didn't do anything wrong. just to report any changes, honest. All I could send word about was the Arl getting sick. After that, monsters started coming from the castle. I don't know anything about these creatures. When the Arl got sick, I got scared that people would think I was involved. But I swear I don't know anything about it. They sent me to watch. Maybe they knew the Arl would get sick. I don't know. Here, this is a letter from them. It has instructions and everything. Keep it. Do whatever you want with it. I just thought I was serving the king and making a bit of coin on the side. You have to believe me. Oh, all right. I'll do it. Thank you for your mercy. I won't forget it.
We're pretty damn efficient, really. We show up, and less than an hour later, we've got the entire town whipped into shape.
I am not the king, and there's nothing glorious about me.
You are Merrick's son. You are the rightful king of Ferelden.
I am the son of a star-struck maid and an indiscreet man who just happened to be king. Look. I can't be king. Sometimes I have trouble figuring out which boot goes on which foot.
Complete fools are made leaders of kingdoms all the time, and you're not a complete fool.
What an utter relief.
And don't worry about the boots. Kings don't need to dress themselves. That's what advisors are for, isn't it?
And star-struck maids, apparently.
Yes, what can I do for you? I knew this time would come. I should have listened to my wife. Don't sign that paper, she said. They might pay you a few sovereigns now, but they'll be back. Blast. I'll see you on the front lines, I suppose.
The task is finished.
From the castle?
As it has been for days, it is an unnatural state.
Say no more.
Standing.
The Arl lives,
no,
and I will
trouble
not
down
listen
in
to
the
your
village.
Suspicious chatter.
Greetings, Grey Warden. I am as relieved as Ban Tegan is to see you here. I must admit, I do not know quite how to address you. Is my lady sufficient? Very well then, my lady. I am humbly at your service. I am Sir Perth, until recently in direct service of Arl Eamon of Redcliffe. For now, my charge is defending the village from these evil assaults. Would that I had chosen not to seek out the Urn of Sacred Ashes. Perhaps I would have fended off whatever evil befell the castle, or perhaps I would be dead. Ah, well, with a Grey Warden aiding our defense, perhaps all is not lost. When the Isle fell sick, we were at a loss. Nothing worked to cure him, and he just kept getting worse. Finally, our lesser Isolde came up with a plan. The Urn of Sacred Ashes is a legendary artifact set to hold great healing powers. If found, it might save him.
They say the followers of Andraste smuggled her ashes out of Tevinter and hid them in Ferelden. The urn's never been heard of since.
We knights volunteered to seek it out. Few of us have returned. Many are still out there, unaware of what is happening here.
Can't tell him that. Yeah, we found that.
As you wish. No one told me of this. Oil, you say? How much exactly? Assuming that would hurt them. Yes, I see what you have in mind. That might be effective, if used carefully. Yes, excellent idea. I'll send some men to collect the oil. We'll use it to slow these creatures down. Have you anything else to ask me in the meantime? We have sufficient armor and weapons, but my knights are too few to stand against the monsters without assistance. Perhaps you could approach Mother Hannah in the Chantry for some holy protection against these evil creatures. Otherwise, I do not know what else you could provide beyond your own talents. We're as prepared for the onslaught as we could possibly be, all things considered. That gladdens my heart to hear it. As you wish, my lady. Maker, watch over you.
As you say. You are a stranger amongst us, yet you still agree to defend our village in its darkest hour. We are most grateful to you. I will be grateful of your attempt, even if it fails. We can ask no more. Allow me to introduce myself. I am revered Mother Hannah, head of this chantry, which for the moment is a place of refuge for these poor villagers.
Surely this cannot be the entire village. These few are all who are left?
All those who cannot defend themselves, yes. They are terrified of tonight's attack, and I fear these walls will not keep them safe. What can I do to help with your task? I have done all I can for them. I pray for them each night and seek the Maker's forgiveness for their sins before they face their deaths. What Sir Perth seeks is something that is not in my power to give. I can pray with them and give them my blessing, but Sir Perth wants me to call upon the Maker to shield them from evil.
Well, can't you just tell him the Maker will watch over him? Morale is a powerful thing, you know.
You mean you want me to let them think the Maker protects them in a real sense? I will not lie to them like that. I suppose if they believed in the Maker's power, that belief would inspire them somewhat. It just seems like trickery. Very well. If it keeps them alive, I will do what I must. I have a number of silver-cast holy symbols. Tell Sir Perth that he can have them, and that wearing them will confer the Maker's protection. Now please, let me tend to these poor folk. I must do what I can, and I suggest you do the same.
Gonna sell these knights some snake oil.
Bevan said you were the one who found him. I can't possibly repay you. Bevan told me about Grandfather's sword. So you have it, then? I suppose it won't go to waste, at least. I have no idea what it's worth, to be honest. And you found Bevan. I couldn't ask you for money. That's incredibly kind of you. Thank you so much. How can I ever repay you? The Maker sent you. I just know it. Thank you again.
That's just for a... That gives a new ending slot for a certain character by paying for that sword. One more trip back up the hill.
The Knights of Redcliffe are ready to fight at your disposal. Have you spoken to the revered mother? Has she offered anything?
Must we do this? The faith that will protect these men must come from their heart, surely.
If they are the same as the symbols worn by their priests, well, that would more than suffice.
That's kind of hypocritical of Liliana. Like, she joined us because the Maker told her to. But we can't give these little guys, these guys a morale boost.
I will send some men to collect the amulets. Please give my regards to Mother Hannah for seeing some sense at last. As you wish, my lady. Maker watch over you.
Well, that's all the preparation, so... Next episode, we'll start the Battle of Redcliffe.